Good morning, everybody. I'm Dr. Soni from Continental Carbo India Limited. I'm working there as advisor R&D, and I'm here to just discuss about the sustainable plastic waste management initiative taken by Himachal Pradesh and the strategy developed by, you can say, Department of Environment, and mainly this was the work done by State Pollution Control Board and how this was implemented in the state of Himachal Pradesh. I'm just going to discuss about the all the from concept to policy, how we implemented, how we developed and how we implement. I hope you all know that plastic waste is totally banned in the state of Himachal Pradesh. But banning is not the complete solution, because there are many other sources which contribute to generation of plastic waste. So how to have a strategy, how to plan it so that we can have sustainable plastic waste management? That was the objective behind this. And this was a community driven program undertaken across the state, and we tried to involve each and every one in the state, and like we involved panchayats, urban local bodies, yuvak mandals, mahila mandals, NGOs, eco clubs, including industry association, hotel association, authorized officers, other government officers and general public, etc. Why to manage plastic waste? Actually, you know, as such, there is no problem with the plastic carry bags, because this is polyethylene. But the problem is that this has harmful impact on the health and natural environment. Because why? Because this is non-biodegradable. It takes more than 100,000 years for its decomposition, and polythene bags can reduce the soil fertility. This is the impact on the soil, you can say, and ultimately that reduces the crop production. And animals such as cows, stray dogs, they eat polythene bags by mistaking them for food, causing animals mortality. So what was the objectives? What were the objectives of the initiative? These were threefold: to ban the use of plastic carry bags, to identify an environment-friendly solution for the disposal of plastic waste, and to deal sustainably with the issue of littering of plastic waste. Then, actually, the initiative was conceived to be implemented in three stages. First, we wanted to create awareness. So creating an enabling framework, that was stage one. Then we wanted to make aware about the what we want to do, what is the strategy, that was stage two, and then consolidation and sustainability. That was the third stage. Now we'll take up one by one. Creating an enabling framework. Actually, what we want to do with this plastic waste, we need to have some technologies, the solution, so that we can, awareness is second stage. First, we should know what we are going to do with this plastic waste. So that was the, not only this, we were also supposed to have proper legal framework also. And how to, because if suppose we have some technology, we want to do something and we strategize how to use it. But there we need to have some legal framework, legal backing also for this. So first was technological solution. We initiated co-processing of plastic waste in cement kilns, and then we demonstrated the use of plastic waste in road construction. That was the second option. We thought this will be the best solution for managing plastic waste. So this is how we demonstrated use of plastic waste in road construction. We collected the plastic waste, then we procured one shredder to shred the plastic waste. Then we collected it, and then actually we engaged one scientist from Thyagraja College of Engineering, Madurai, And he actually educated us on the method, how to use it in the road construction. And we involved him during demonstration. And then we shredded it, and how to use it, he told us. And all the time he was with us. Then you can see the pictures here. And this demonstration we did at Jubarhatti Airport Road in Shimla. In this demonstration, actually this demo road which we constructed was approximately 800 meters. And shredded plastic waste used was 530 kilograms. And the type of plastic waste used, you know, we used almost everything, like carry bags, disposable cups, thermocoles, laminated plastics like pouches of chips, pan masala, aluminium foil, and packaging material used for biscuits, chocolates, milk, grocery, etc. And but here, no PVC was used. And then the test report of the samples collected from the demo road by PWD showed increased strength as well as better resistance towards rainwater and water stagnation. The waste plastic replaces approximately 10 to 15% of the bitumen, you know, because this bitumen, this plastic waste, when we add it to the aggregate, this totally covers the aggregate. And the voids, these are also you can say filled this plastic waste, and this saves approximately 35,000 to 45,000 per kilometer of a road stretch. Then this is the regulatory framework, because for plastic waste, as I told you earlier also, we have to have very strong regulatory backing for this. And the regulatory framework, I can just tell you about the regulation we have in Himachal Pradesh. First of all, Government of Himachal Pradesh formulated HP Non-Biodegradable Garbage Control Act 1995 to deal with the littering of non-biodegradable garbage and to manage the solid waste disposal in a scientific manner. This initiative was taken in 1995. And this, the act came into force with effect from 31st August 1998 and amended from time to time. After this, prohibition was imposed to throw non-biodegradable waste in places other than the garbage receptacles, dustbins provided, or location designated by local authorities. Government of Himachal Pradesh imposed prohibition on the traders, retailers, and vendors in the state of HP for using the colored polythene carry bags manufactured from recycled plastics for packaging the goods traded sold by them with effect from 1st January 1999. So the ban was only on the colored plastic carry bags. And then Government of Himachal Pradesh imposed prohibition on the stockists, traders, retailers, vendors of all kind of commodities within the entire state of Himachal Pradesh for using carry bags made of non-biodegradable material having thickness less than 70 microns and size less than 12 into 18 inches with effect from 14th June 2004. And then again, HP imposed complete ban. This was the last step. Complete ban on polythene plastic carry bags, irrespective of their sizes and thickness, made of non-biodegradable material and littering of non-biodegradable waste with effect from 2nd October 2009. And the penal provisions. Penal up to 1,000 grams. If you find plastic with anybody up to 1,000 grams, then amount penalty amount was 500, and accordingly more than 100 up to 500, that was 1,500. And this is not only the quantity of the plastic material, but on littering also there was penalty, and littering of plastic waste by any institution, it was 5,000, and littering of plastic waste by individuals, it was 1,000 rupees. And then authorities who can take cognizance of the violation, these were the prescribed authorities: police, health department, excise and taxation, district administration, environment science and technology, urban development. And the authorized officers, you can see all SPs, ASPs, SDPOs, etc. You can say we try to cover maximum officers in the various departments so that we can really enforce the rules. So these are the authorized officers. Further, in 2004, we found that we need to add more officers. So in 2010, we added maximum officers of the different departments. You can just see in tourism, like all district and assistant tourism development officers were there in 2004. These were the authorized officers. But in 2010, we covered all GMs, DGMs, AGMs, and managers of HPTDC. Now the second, this is second stage. Now we have technology with us. Now we have regulatory framework with us. But there was need to make people aware of about the technologies and how to collect it and what should be the method, how to collect and then how this will go to the, who can use it for road construction, etc. How the strategy was made, I'll explain it later. But second stage was awareness made to the general public, to different departments from all the agencies. And we called it Polythene Hatao Forever. Phase 1 took place from 21st to 26th December 2009, and the objective was to create awareness. Phase 1 was launched by the then Honorable Chief Minister, and the event took place in Dharamsala, District Kangra. And during this phase, whosoever was there, we tried to invite all the schools and for general public. MCs were very active during this event. And you know, everybody tried to collect plastic waste from the hill slopes. And the waste which we collected during that phase, that was sent to Noorpur PWD office. And there it was used for road construction. You can see just pictures, and these are the newspaper cuttings. Not only plastic waste, we thought we must distribute some pamphlets so that people can understand a little more about the environment. These are the do's and don'ts distributed through the pamphlets. Then we prepared one conservation code also, some startling facts we distribute through these pamphlets, and we appealed to the general public and also to the school children. It was made mandatory for the school children to take oath of this conservation code after prayer hour. These are some of the pictures of that event only, and then these are the awareness programs through school children. Because you know, school children, it is very necessary to make any program successful to involve students in that, because they are extended, you can say, arms of the society, and through them it is really you can make any program successful. So next is consolidation and sustainability. This was stage 3. Now we have technology with us, we have made general public, we have tried to make people aware of what we want to do. So then how to consolidate and how to make it sustainable, that was stage 3. In stage 3 there were again two phases. Phase 2 we covered 26 April. Again this is the same campaign, Polythene Hatao Paryavaran Bachao. During this, actually what we did, we developed a sustainable mechanism for procurement of plastic. What mechanism was this? Deputy commissioners were asked to notify all the collection centers identified, opened by ULBs, panchayats within their area of jurisdiction. Because if plastic is collected, this has to go to some collection center. Otherwise, where to keep it? That was the problem. So we wanted all the urban local bodies and panchayats, etc., to have collection center, and deputy commissioners were required to notify these collection centers. And the deputy commissioners to register the NGOs, organizations, institutions, kabaddis, door-to-door waste collectors affiliated with the registered collection centers. And polythene plastic waste collected by the registered NGOs, organizations, institutions, kabaddis, door-to-door waste collectors was decided to be sold at rupees 3 per kg at the registered collection center. And from the collection center, the polythene plastic waste to be lifted by the junior engineer of PWD to the shredding yard by paying rupees 4 per kg. This 1 rupee per kg was kept for cleanliness of the collection centers, for maintenance of the collection centers. And then PWD to nominate junior engineers responsible for lifting waste from each registered collection center. This was the mechanism developed, institutionalized for sustainable implementation of the management system. Then sustainability. Then we thought there is still needed further to do something, because this will not be sufficient to have collection centers. What is already there on the hill slopes, we need to clean that also. So what we did, this was the, you can say, during this phase only, we took up this activity also. This was zero tolerance strategy for plastic waste management. The components of the program were, we identified hotspots, means where we were finding plastic waste lying on the hill slopes, etc. Then we cleaned the hotspots, then opening of collection center, then transportation of collected waste plastic to the collection centers, and lifting of collected waste plastic by PWD, then identification, construction of road stretches for use of plastic in road construction by PWD by using plastic coated bitumen. So you can see some pictures. These are the plastic tar road constructed during phase 2. We constructed about 42 kilometers of road stretch during this phase 2. Then just to felicitate the various people, you can say the students, etc., we kept a function also. This was inaugural function of Polythene Hatao Paryavaran Bachao campaign phase 2. This is felicitation during phase 2 of the campaign. You can see various pictures here. And these are the, you can see, these are the hotspots we identified. Some of the hotspots identified. This is in New Shimla, Sector 1. And you can just see the upper one, that shows the picture before cleaning, and the lower one, this is after cleaning. And you can just see the comparison. This is Vikas Nagar by Fast Road. This is again one location in Shimla. You can see various pictures here, before and after cleaning. This is Miss Chamber Kalini, Kochera College area. You can just see, these are various pictures. Then phase 3 of Polythene Hatao Paryavaran Bachao, the last phase. And now the objective was monitoring and regulation. Now we have legal framework. Now we have technology with us. We have made people aware of this thing. But we need to monitor how much is the enforcement. So effective monitoring to ensure compliance with respect to ban on use of plastic polythene carry bags and on littering of non-biodegradable waste, that was the objective. And to strengthen the mechanism devised for sustainable plastic waste management through eco-monitoring scheme and environment audit scheme. This we did through schools, this eco-monitoring and environment audit scheme. And then components of the program. First of all, we made aware to the authorized officers about the powers delegated to compound any offence on the ban aforesaid. Then again, we made them aware about cleaning of hotspots, then constitution of teams, team leaders of the authorized officers to compound any offence on ban on the ban aforesaid, and constitution of teams and leaders of eco monitors. Means again, we are making aware the teams constituted for monitoring. First, we made them aware about the problem, about the solutions, and the strategy how to do it. Now we are monitoring this is the monitoring of the you can say enforcement of the legal thing we have with us. Then progress review of phase 1 of the 1 and 2 of the campaign, that was also the component of this program. And then last was launch of and this was in Hindi, so I don't have that software with me. Anyway, Green School Assessment Scheme and Environment Audit Scheme, that was launched during this phase. You can just see flagging off of the eco-monitoring contingents. These are the eco-monitoring schemes we distributed to the schools, and how to do is we conducted many programs with the schools, and I'll just show you the pictures. This is the eco-monitoring scheme. So we conducted many training programs. You can just see we tried to involve most of the schools in the state of Himachal Pradesh, and these are some pamphlets distributed to them, and training given on environment audit, how to do environment audit of their schools, how so that they can understand what is the problem and what could be the solutions and how to manage it and how to make it sustainable. And you can just see there are different pictures. And now, during monitoring, this is the district-wise progress of the polythene collection during the campaigns. You can just see different districts of the Himachal Pradesh, and during phase 1, how much polythene was collected. You can just see 141 tons. It was in tons, yes, total in tons. And then phase 2, 93. Because in phase 1 we could collect most of the plastic, and there was awareness also. Now this decrease, you can just see, you can see the implementation successfulness of the implementation, because after 141 it reduced to 93. And then because people, they also stopped littering plastic waste. In phase 3 we collected only 75.969 tons of the waste, and the total collection was 311.134. Then, yes, this is in continuation to the earlier style as slide. Total quantum of plastic waste collected in tons, phase 1 program during the polythene hatao paryavaran bachao campaign. Okay, in that we collected 141.93.311. It's same. And total number of hotspots identified, you can say phase 2, 2,545 hotspots were identified. And in phase 3, we identified 30. And total number of hotspots clean, 1,750 we could clean, and 293 during phase 3. And then total number of collection centers opened, 1,061 during phase 2 and 700 during phase 3. And whatever we took up in the phase 3, that was the result of the monitoring we started during phase 2. And total, you can say 1,761 numbers of the collection centers we opened, and total plastic handed over to PWD was 102 tons, 0.26. And then total number of stretches identified by PWD were 52 number, and total road stretches 31 numbers, about 33.63 kilometers, but I remember this was 42, maybe it is not covered in this anyway. And total panchayat plastic weight utilized in road construction is 29.52 tons, and bills raised by the DCs to PWD for plastic waste was 32,052. Okay. Then total number of challans, because people were authorized to take cognizance of the violation, and these were the challans and compounded fee on violations, 240 numbers were the challans, and amount compounded was 1,28,350. Total number of challans on violations with respect to littering was also there. It was 1,49,300. Then these are some of the other initiatives for reducing plastic waste. Recycling. Actually, we thought now the in Russian depots also we are using plastic waste. So what to do with that? So it was decided that it will be recycled, and mustard vegetable oil pouches is ensured by way of special move through HP Civil Supply Corporation. The total quantity of 17.06 quintals of plastic waste has been collected by the Civil Supply Corporation to be handed over to PWD for its utilization. In this, what they used to do, they will give ration only if the people return back the empty pouches. So then this was also handed over to PWD. And the biodegradable plastic waste is to be used to forest nurseries to minimize the use of plastic bags, and fisheries departments to use such bags as well for packaging of sea. So we try to reduce biodegradable plastic bags. Then portable water dispensers for tourists were installed to minimize the use of plastic bottle water through HPTDC. This was a very good initiative taken by HPTDC. And the water purifiers were installed at Shimla, Manali, Chamba towns, and the process of installation at other different tourist places like Dharamsala, Dalhousie, Kullu, so that we can reduce the use of bottled plastic this water. And HP excise and taxation department was also in the process of replacement of plastic pouches by glass bottles in a time-bound manner. And HP Milk Federation is likely to start printing a this is the status as of 2010. So these are some you can say oath we ask people to take. And then enabling initiatives, detailed implementation guidelines were issued for facilitating the prescribed authorities. We prepared guidelines, we distributed to them, and so that they just go through this. If you, they have any problem, they can just take the help of this guideline. And then district level and for wide block level functionaries were notified as prescribed authorities, fully empowered for taking cognizance of the violation. And we conferred Prime Minister's Award for this. So that's all about the plastic waste management in the state of Himachal. Thank you.